Hey guys, Robin Rosado here, Director of Instruction for Top Speed Golf Orlando. And I've got a great drill for you, for those who are kind of struggling to get that nice, good compression, get that good compression line like we talk about in the Top Speed system, and also hitting those irons super nice and solid and getting those hands, getting a little bit of that shaft plane of impact. So this drill is gonna really help out with that. And it's super simple and really easy to do. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna feel, is you're gonna sit up to the ball like you normally would. I got a 7-iron in my hands. I like to keep with an iron, and I have it teed up too as well, just so I can, because I'm working on something, I'm doing a drill, so I always want to have it a little bit teed up sometimes, so you can make some good solid contact on the ball instead of having to sit it down on the turf. So I got a 7-iron here. I'm going to play in my normal stance, get my normal adjust position, and right before when I'm ready to hit the ball, I'm going to feel like what I want to be, like an impact. So impact for me, my hips are about 45 degrees open, shoulders a little square, and my weight is a little bit more on my left side, right? So I'm gonna sit up to the ball like a four, I'm gonna hit it, and I'm gonna get into what I say the impact position right there. So this is how my hands are ahead. I got a nice good shaft lane on the ball. My hips are a little bit open. My weight is now starting to shift onto my left side. So I can feel that. The reason why this is a good drill, you can do that about 2 to 3 times. Again, kind of like just feeling that. And I want you to feel like you're almost like those hands are pressing down a little bit like you would a normal shot. Again, feeling that right hand cover the ball just a little bit. Don't want to press down too hard. If you press down too hard, then I give you the feeling of like you really need to dig down into the ground. And then just get a little bit, just get those hips a little bit of weight over there. So again, feel that motion there. Feel like you're pressing a little bit forward, a little bit forward and down, not a ton, just a little bit. And that gives you the same, that gives me that kind of last minute feeling of impact before I actually hit the ball. So again, I'm gonna do about 2 to 3 times. Here's one, feeling that same thing. Two, feel that same thing. My hips are rotating, a little weight. And then just go ahead and hit the ball and try to mimic that same shot like you just did. Nice, right out on target. So all that does is gives you the last feeling of impact before you actually hit the ball. So those who are, again, those who are kind of struggling with the shaft lane or trying to get some good compression on the ball, this gives you that good feeling right before you hit it. So then you can transfer it. Once you go to actually hit it, you have that same, you have to know what that actually feels like. All right, guys, so give it a shot. Give it a try out there. Let us know how you do. Good luck, play well. Also, check out our Instagram. We just started at Top Speed Golf. Go ahead and follow us there and take a look at those videos that we have on there. All right, guys, thanks. Have fun. Hey, guys, I hope you really enjoyed that video. I've got an even better video to help you out, because you know we all want to try to hit a little bit further, maybe hit a little bit better. So go ahead and click that I card and somewhere on your screen there, and it'll take you to our website. We're going to talk about the move and talk about how to get a little bit more lag. It's also going to introduce you to that tennis racket drill that we have on there. And through there, you can have access to our 5 points of our Top Speed Golf system. And that you can have and really get some detail on the golf swing and help you get, give you some good drills and some good thoughts you can do to help you work it out and get hit the ball really well. All right, guys, so good luck out there. Have fun and play well.
Good player problems. We're going to talk about shallowing that club shaft out as we're starting down, as we're doing this rotating of the face that we worked on in the last video. As we start this downswing, what you'll see with basically all of the top players is, instead of coming kind of over the top and letting the hands come out away from their body, letting the club come out away from their body, again coming down steep into the ball and then having to open up, kind of fillet open the face and add loft to it, the flattening of the shaft should happen as soon as we start down. So as we start this downswing, what we want to have happening here, you can imagine that if I draw a line from the hosel of my club up through my right elbow, that's my swing plane line, my elbow plane. As I go to the top of the swing, I'm going to be slightly above that. And then as I start down, I want my hands to start to shallow out. I want the club to shallow out inside of this elbow plane. And at the same time, I'm going to be rotating my hands.